welcome back to another video with me Shruti Vashisht. You're watching Living Our Ascension. So today, because we have the Pleiadian Gateway active now, I wanted to do a reading for all of us, just, you know, these guidance messages. But I hope that the messages that come through today will be of some assistance to you during this beautiful time of the galactic Pleiadian Gateway, where we, you know, go through so many galactic initiations basically. And especially those souls who belong to the Pleiades constellation or are somehow associated with it, you know, their mission involves this, especially would benefit. But really, it's just for everyone. So a lot of galactics work with us at this time, and it's a good idea to be in places of nature, which is why you can see, you know, I'm here in the mountains and just surrounded by these really beautiful places in the mountains. A little later, perhaps I'll put in some clips of this area. It's called Parvati River. It's in Kasol, which is in Himachal Pradesh in India. And just this really beautiful place. So if you want to hear the messages, then please keep watching this video. Give it a thumbs up if you want to watch more videos like this. And subscribe if you're new here. And also check out my website, which has all kinds of personal services. It's livingourascension.com. There's personal services with me to accelerate your self-mastery and enlightenment. So these days I usually do these readings on my Instagram, so you can check them out there. And I'm also leaving you with some clips of this beautiful place, and then we will begin the messages. So I've come up here to Nagar Castle. From the outside, this is the castle. We're gonna go inside, but that's the view from the outside. You get a good enough view, honestly. Ooh, violet tree. That's such a big tree. And it snowed here last night. It was like raining cats and dogs on this hill that I'm at. And around all these other hills on the other side had snow. I don't think you can see back there. So yeah, that's what the view looks like from up here. There's a 30 rupee fee to get inside, so we'll see if it's anything different from what you can see here from the outside. Hey guys, so this is the view from inside Nagar Castle. I took a few shots that I'll show you. But yeah, it's a really nice 360 view and definitely worth coming here, in here. It's empty at the moment because I'm guessing because of coronavirus, and looks like, you know, people can eat here. But right now I'm the only one inside. 5 minutes ago there were these two other couples. And so it's really nice with the wooden work and, of course, the view, the amazing view of the valley and the mountains. So the name of this river is Parvati River, and we're in this place called Kasol in Himachal Pradesh in India. Just on this trek, and there's a hike, but I don't think we have time today because I'm leaving. I'm heading back to Delhi and I have a bus, and it also looks like it might rain. What I'm going to do is I'm going to show you three stones that I picked up. Just on my walk here, we walked quite a bit in and then we headed back because it looks like it might rain. So there's three stones that I have, and you just have to choose one, and then whichever one you choose, you'll get a message. So first I'm just going to show you, I'm going to flash a picture of the three stones. They will be sitting on on a turquoise rock. Turquoise, by the way, is the color of the Pleiades. It's the ray associated with Pleiadian souls. And the water behind me is like that. You know, the color turquoise has just been following me. Right now it's kind of cloudy, so it looks a little bit more green. But when we came in the morning, it was completely turquoise, the water here. So, have a look at that picture and choose one stone first. Okay guys, so stone number one is this one. It's the white and crimson colored one. So this basically relates to the I Am Presence. I'm sure many of you will know about this, that this is the I Am, the colors of the I Am Presence, the red and copper and white. And the I Am Presence is our God Self. So I feel that, you know, what you can do this week during this Galactic Pleiadian Gateway is you can connect deeper to your I Am Presence. And the I Am Presence, you know, is a high vibrational frequency. But at the same time, it's very grounded. It's the frequency, the vibration of the master, the human master, you know. That's why it has the color red in it, because it's as much about grounding as it is about connecting to the light. That's why the combination of white and red or crimson. And that's when a person becomes a Buddha or a Christ. So I feel that there's some grounded codes that are coming for you now. And what I mean by that is that, you know, you may have known spirituality a certain way, you may have known yourself to be a spiritual being, but something at this week is making you more grounded in that. It's showing you how it looks on Earth, you know, what does it look like on Earth, basically. Because we have this perspective, it's about things that are a little bit more intangible. And these spiritual principles, but what does that look like on the planet? And each time that these type of codes come through for us, it's very, very fulfilling in the body. You know, like we really get it. Then we might think that we get something when we just get a concept, but it's just over here. It's at a concept level, and it might make us feel grander and larger than life. But what the red part of it does, what the grounding part of it does, is it really anchors us here. In the here and now, in the body, in our sensuality. So I feel that, you know, it's going to make you feel, make your life a little bit more simple. So perhaps you had all of these ideas and you didn't know how they really applied in your life, or at least, you know, at this time it's going to be coming through in a new way, the way that they apply in your life. You know, that feeling when we are practically sorted and we know what we are doing. And it's just going to ground you in that feeling of being alive and feeling good in the body, feeling provided for. And just, you know, even if you have to get rid of some things, whether it's relationships, whether it's perspectives, whether it's your past wounds, because we don't actually have wounds as such. But, you know, when we really associate with that at a feeling level, like we're feeling those emotions, so they exist only because of that. So whatever you have to let go of that no longer serves you, you'll let go of it easily and you'll embrace simplicity, and it's really going to serve you. It's the making of the master, basically. This is what you're landing, the vibration of the I Am Presence, your God Self. So I hope that message was helpful for you. You can connect to your Pleiadian guides. Just, you know, all you have to do is close your eyes and call on the Pleiadians, call on the Galactics to connect with you and to bring you grounded messages. Another way of grounding, of course, is coming into nature. So whatever grounding means to you, you might want to do that this week as well. Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe if you're new here and give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed your message. So the next stone I have for you, of course, is this one. And this is a kind of like a milky quartz. It's already crystallized to some degree. I don't know if you can catch it well in the camera, but I can tell you that it's like a milky translucent sort of a stone. So it's the most translucent one out of the ones that were there, you know, amongst the choices. And as I look at it, it looks like a pillar. It's like a pillar of crystalline light. You know, this is in spirituality, we associate this with our white light pillar, which connects us to our higher self. It connects us to our twin soul. It connects us to our I Am Presence. You know, it's like our vertical connection to all of our, all parts of us. And I feel like, you know, it looks almost like there's two. So this has the energy of the twin flame essence that lives within us. And for me, you know, recently how it's been coming up is through embracing new experiences. I'm embracing the beloved in new ways, through new relationships, through putting myself in situations that are out of my comfort zone. You know, even those things that make me feel a little bit more vulnerable, they're either I'm choosing them voluntarily or they're happening on their own. And sometimes you feel a little bit betrayed by life or cheated by life, you know. Like on this travel, I've had weird experiences with hotels and stuff, and just wondering, you know, why did this happen? Because, you know, it doesn't happen to me often. And yeah, but it's sometimes it's not about something that you need to see within yourself. So I feel like the beloved is bringing you initiations, and you have to realize that the beloved is all around. Like, I speak of the beloved in the way that Rumi speaks of the beloved, you know, the beloved essence that lives within everything. Because when we were created first just by Source, and we were born as this twin flame spark, basically, the only way that we know something that is not me, something that is you, all of that is the beloved. So whether that's this mountain, this river, or the people around me, everything, my experience of another is actually the experience of the beloved. So, you know, if I'm having some sort of a struggle with that, then that shows me where I'm not allowing the beloved to just come through, where I'm not trusting that there is something larger that exists, you know. This trinity, this holy trinity that exists, that plays out in everything that I do. This trinity of me, my twin flame, and my higher self. And that's like a temple, like a triangle that I always carry no matter where I am. And within that, you know, everything happens for my highest good and for service, for the service that this trinity brings on the planet. So let me see what else is here. So that was explaining what it's all about at a light level. But I feel that relationships are coming to you now. You know, there's love that is around in one way or another. And it's love in a new way, and love in a way, you know, like how when people are in a relationship for a really long time, they gather this wisdom. It's like there's no hurry in it. Like there's, of course, it's beautiful to have that time when it feels like you're falling in love for the first time. So that's, of course, there, that magic. But at the same time, there's this beauty that is there that's, you know, more mature. That is this feeling of knowing that, for example, if you've been married for really long, that my partner is always here for me, you know, and having that security, and not being in a hurry to experience things, knowing that your partner's always there, you know, that steady, stable feeling of knowing that I have this, that this is mine. You know, when I come home, my partner is there. Like, or perhaps if you've never felt it about a person, then you feel it about your home, knowing that, you know, when I come back from work, home is always there. It's something I can rely on. It's something that is there. So I feel that's coming into your relationships, and it might even be a new relationship if, you know, it's what you're looking for. Or it might be new relationships generally with people. But there's new relationship energy that's coming into your existing relationships or through new relationships. And it's bringing more maturity, it's bringing more wisdom, it's bringing more stability. You'll be able to honor within simplicity what you have, rather than looking for many things. Or, you know, expecting people, let's say, to be perfect, or yourself in relationships to be perfect in all ways. Just embracing within simplicity that we're all human, and honoring what you have, seeing the beloved playing out behind that. And that's really going to enrich your relationship experience, you know. Often we're looking for the perfect one, the perfect relationship, or the perfect connection. But perfection always is, it always exists. And we experience it when we can witness it, when we hold space to witness it. And that's happening for you now. And through that, some beautiful blessings are coming, because this is a really beautiful stone. It's like the meeting of the lover and the beloved, you know, in the purest way. And you'll definitely be feeling that this week. And like I've been saying in every, for every choice, connect to your Pleiadian guides, and get some wisdom, you know, ask for whatever wisdom is right for you. As I say this, there's this dog that's coming up that's like beige or white and black, which are the colors of the beloved. I'll show you right here, you know, like the yin yang, sort of. At least that's what he looked like from a distance. So there he is, this beautiful mountain dog. There's this dog that, oh, he stopped right next to me. There's this dog that was following us. You know, he was our guide. He was leading us. That was a white dog. And now there's this black dog that's here. So you see, there's this energy of the yin yang that is around you. Yeah, so really bask in that, enjoy it, and call on your Pleiadian guides and you know, perhaps even connect to the twin soul essence within through that. And call on your Trinity. And again, places of nature are always best during these beautiful portals. So find time to do that. Even if you don't have access to a lot of nature, find time to go outside on a walk and find some quiet time to connect within. Because there's some codes that are there for you. But they'll be felt in anything that you're doing, you know, just normal tasks as well. So thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you're new here, and I'll see you next time. Okay guys, so if you chose this one, it's light blue in color. You can't really see it on camera, but it's like a light blue colored stone. And the color light blue, it relates to the Divine Mother. It's the ray of the Divine Mother. So I really feel that there's this, you know, during this Pleiadian gateway, first of all, blue is one of the colors of the Pleiades. I mean, it's turquoise. But at a higher level, because the Pleiadians were the ones, were one of the ones to sort of seed. And the Pleiadians are connected to the elder energy, you know, the elders who gave birth to all of creation. So they're somehow connected to that as well. And so there's a higher aspect, you know, that is light blue, that has to do with the Divine Mother realms, where all of creation happens, you know, through the Divine Mother, through the feminine principle. And it's a really soft color. It's a very warming, nurturing color as well. So I feel that that's what's happening for you now. You know, this through something that is happening in your life right now, the messages that are coming, and it might be that you've had a sort of a tough time recently, or you're realizing you're feeling perhaps a little bit more alone in the world, or somehow, like, you know, like you need a mother, almost like you need a parent, and you feel like that's been missing. Or you've been feeling alone somehow, and I feel that there's, like, it's almost like this week there's this the essence that is coming in is like a balm. It's like a soothing balm to the heart, for it to heal, you know, for it to experience healing, for it to experience wholeness, really, what it really is, just how whole you are within, you know, how you are this precious child of the Divine Mother, how you were created by the elders. And through that, perhaps even some light codes are coming, because again, this is a high vibrational ray. It relates to nurture and this feminine principle of care, and just this love of all life. That is how everything in creation is born, through feeling this absolute and utter love that has no agenda, you know, except just witnessing the love of source. And through that, just something is birthed, you know, creation happens through that. So it's that pure. And you'll be feeling warmth in your heart, you know, you'll be feeling a sense of connection, whether it's to relationships, it'll be generally to life and generally to your own existence as well. Watch out for codes as well, because like I said, this is a high vibrational ray. So watch out for codes that are coming through this week. It might come through nature messages, because again, this ray is also very much connected to nature, you know, because it's like the turquoise, the pale blue ray of Divine Mother. And Mother Earth is like a more physical representation for us, you know, locally here. So I feel like Mother Earth will be bringing you some gifts, you know, just like I've been walking here, I picked up these stones and they brought me some guidance, and I'm sharing it with everyone. And more than that, it's bringing me this experience of just being here. I haven't been to the mountains, I don't know, in a year or something. And it's just so refreshing, something my soul really needed. So I feel that there are some codes yet to come for us, and they are just showing you how you were born, because this is about that original birth, you know, through the Divine Mother, through the elders, and it's a lot about your birth, basically, from source. So there's codes coming through that will really bring you a sense of being cared for, being the precious child that you are, and showing you what you are. So yeah, I hope that message resonated with you. Let me see if there's anything else that I want to say. I think that's it, pretty much. I'm getting the sense that these messages are coming from the monad or the mind of God realms, again a very high vibration, you know, similar to this ray. So it might be a good time for you to tap into the mind of God, to the universal mind. Just find yourself a place of nature perhaps, or a quiet place, and channel through the wisdom that comes through, and something new might be birthing for you this way, or there might be some wisdom for you specifically. Connect to the galactics, to your Pleiadian guides. And just as I'm saying this, you know, this something from the tree fell. I think it's an acorn, like that pine thing fell. And there's gifts for you in nature. If you find nature gifts, because I began saying this and I didn't complete, so thank you so much for that. If you find gifts like that in nature, then they have some sort of symbolism, some sort of meaning for you as well this week. And they relate to your soul codes. So yeah, that's all that I want to say. Connect to the universal mind for that, and it'll enhance your physical experiences and the gifts and experiences that you have in the physical too. So thank you so much for watching, and give this video a thumbs up if you like this message, and subscribe if you're new here. I'll see you very soon, and bye. Thank you.